Autism was first identified in the 1940s and really wasn't widely recognised until the 70s. What we know about older adults with autism is very little, so it's only now that those first diagnosed people are reaching late life that we can begin to look at what happens to people with autism as they age. In the study that has just been published, we've worked with colleagues at the Autism Diagnostic Centre in Southampton, where adults come for a diagnosis of autism. People who are older have more autism traits rather than fewer autism traits. So you may expect that actually, if you've made it to 60 without having a diagnosis of autism, that perhaps you've got milder traits of autism. And that's not what we're seeing in this sample. These people have quite severe autism traits, but they also have quite high cognitive abilities, which may actually help them to compensate. So they may have developed strategies over their lifespan in order to cope with some of the difficulties that they would experience in autism. What we really want to do next is to look at how these people change over time. So there are likely to be differences between somebody who's 20 who's getting a first diagnosis and somebody who's 60 and is getting a first diagnosis. It's really early days for this autism and aging work, and it's a really exciting time to be working in this field. At the moment in the UK, there are 15 million people aged over 60, and that number is going to just continue to grow. I think we all deserve to have the best aging experience that we can, and it's only by asking these questions that we can begin to put things in place to really help people age as well as possible.